please put in my tune.
As you can see tonight, we've decided to swap the comfort of our regular studio for this lonely stable here in the middle of Bethlehem.
That's right, because not long ago, something happened right here on this very spot that will change all of our lives forever.
Who can forget the miraculous events when Jesus was born in this very stable? Tonight we'll remind you of the events of that wonderful night.
And to help us celebrate his birth and hope and love that he brings, we are joined by an exciting lineup of celebrities all ready to dance for us. But three people are dancers must impress this evening.
Let's meet the judges!
He carried the whole show, or at least he carried Mary all the way to the stable. It's the donkey! Never one to get in a flap, she's flown in especially. Please welcome a great friend of Gabriel, the amazing Angel. Some say he has more census than sense. The Roman everyone loves to hate, it's Caesar Augustus.
Well, it may be cold outside, but in here it's time to turn the heat up and go dancing, so please put your hands together.
For the story that will make history, one we'll all be talking about for thousands of years to come. Make some noise and raise the roof for the stars of lights, camera action!
Let's take our story right back to the beginning and talk to the townsfolk of Nazareth.
Time for us all, but just in case anyone out there has been asleep, can you remind us of how it all began?
I remember it well when Caesar sent out one of his decrees.
We all know about those, don't we?
And what did it say?
We.
You'll try to go where we were born.
That's right.
Well, because he came just down the road. No, he had to go 166 miles. They haven't really done yet.
And we saw that woman who was expecting a baby.
I hope your feet have recovered because it's time for you and all your friends to dance for the judges.
Dancing a line dance, the people of Nazareth!
And you, and us, and them, and it.
with our judges.
Angel, what an opener to the show.
What can I say? That was fantastic. I love the way you all meet together. So a great task to open the celebration.
Donkey, what did you think?
Well, we've all got great movies and I loved the show of Sunday Afternoon. But I like this in a little more, especially from you in the front.
And Caesar, can you tell us what you think?
Well, darling, you... it was controlled, your moves were together, and it worked well as an ensemble performance. I thought it was terrific.
That's brilliant. And how do you feel about that? Are you happy with the judges' comments?
I'm so happy.
Fantastic. Well, even though we are just scoring for fun this evening, let's hope the marks for our first set of scores are good ones.
Judges, could we have your scores, please?
A!
Brilliant.
Next up, we have all rides on the Easter camel.
I know you've travelled a long way to be here tonight, but it's not the first time you've been on this journey, is it?
It certainly isn't. I remember we were left in the desert when we were approached by three important looking men.
They told us that they were very wise and they had read their king would be born soon. They'd wanted to go and worship him.
They said the brightest star in the sky would guide them. It all sounded very exciting, and to be honest, the desert was getting pretty boring.
They wanted us to take them to the king with their presents, so they thought, why not?
Of course, all three of us were there then, but old Colin got the hump as his mum asked him to come home.
So tonight it's just us.
Well, we have a little surprise for you this evening. Not seen each other since that epic journey, the three wise men.
Greetings, Hermit and Lucinda. Remember I brought gold?
Remember I brought frankincense, you're always in my mind.
Dancing the camel funk, the camels and the wise men.
We can keep our cool in the heat of the day.
Have your scores, please.
Two. Nine.
Yay.
Eight.
Yay.
As we know, the action wasn't just happening on the road that night.
Certainly not. High up in the some shepherds were minding their own business, watching their sheep happily grazing.
All was quiet when suddenly the sky was filled with angels singing happily for us, dancing.
And we are delighted that they've agreed to perform that dance again for us this evening.
Ballet dancing for us, the host of heavenly angels, including our very own angel.
Judges, we have your scores, please.
10!
Whoa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
travel to Bethlehem, where we would find the Son of God lying in the manger.
We weren't sure at first, but the angels were quite persuasive.
So we checked that the sheep were all okay, then we sent them to Bethlehem.
It's true, they left us.
Susan didn't watch the flocks by the way.
What an incredible experience.
And let's hope we can persuade you to dance for us tonight.
Dancing the shepherd's hay, the shepherds and their sheep. Judges, could we have your scores, please?
Three.
Boo.
Could you shed some light
from your part in our story?
It was my job to guide the wise men to the place where the baby Jesus was to be born.
And how did you do that?
Basically, I shone really bright as bright as I possibly could.
I see.
Right over this table so that everyone could see me.
Great, and are you ready to dance for us this evening?
Yes, definitely.
Dancing Disco, the Star of Bethlehem. Could we have your scores, please?
Nine!
Yay!
Nine!
Yay! When Mary and Joseph reached Bethlehem, they needed to find a place to stay.
Not an easy thing to do in a town packed with newly arrived visitors.
And if you needed to find somewhere to stay, who would you call?
Please welcome the innkeepers.
Oh dear.
So it was a pretty busy time for you, I understand.
Busy? That wasn't the half of it. The place was absolutely heaving.
Dancing a tango, the innkeepers of Bethlehem.
tango, but I'm afraid that has all the passion of a wet fish in a paper
bag.
I'm sorry, but the only bit I enjoyed was when it stopped.
Oh, we have your scores, please.
Four.
Boo.
Baby Jesus together with one more dance.